Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Friday, SpaceX successfully launched the Starlink 6-7 mission on a Falcon 9 rocket.
One, engine full power, and liftoff of Starlink. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The boost which launched this mission, B-1062, then landed successfully for the 15th time on the drone ship A Shortfall of Gravitas.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
This Falcon 9 first stage has now successfully launched and landed for its 15th time.
Related to this mission, SpaceX posted SpaceX's 50th mission of the year sends 22 Starlink satellites to orbit while Falcon Heavy readies for tonight's launch. We've been expecting the Falcon Heavy launch this past week, but it's been delayed multiple times, but it finally launched yesterday.
One, ignition, engine full power, and liftoff of Falcon Heavy. Go Falcon 9, go Falcon Heavy, go Echo Star.
The side boosters which launched this mission, B-1064 and B-1065, both landed successfully for the third time on the landing pads Landing Zone 1 and Landing Zone 2.
Both side boosters are transonic.
Boosters are transonic on their way back to land at LZs 1 and 2.
Side booster landing burn.
Landing burn has started.
Side booster landing leg deploy. Side booster landing confirmed.
That is absolutely incredible, and as you can see, our team is thrilled.
Stage 2 FPS saved.
With that, we have successfully landed both Falcon Heavy side boosters on landing zones 1 and 2. That marks the 211th and 212th overall successful landing of an orbital class rocket.
There was a post from SpaceX related to this Falcon Heavy launch. It says Falcon Heavy launches SpaceX's 250th successful mission overall. We can also hopefully expect to see another launch this coming week. The Galaxy 37 Horizons 4 mission is currently scheduled for Thursday, August 3rd at 4:15 a.m. UTC or 12:15 a.m. EDT. There was a post about Starlink related to its durability. It says Starlink is rugged enough to withstand extreme cold, heat, hail, sleet, heavy rain and gale force winds, to be determined on volcanoes. With the news of SpaceX looking to double its revenue this year, there was an article posted about this. It says if SpaceX succeeds in achieving this revenue forecast, Euroconsult estimates that upwards of 40% of these revenues or $3.2 billion could be attributable to the broadband connectivity services of Starlink. Heading to Boca Chica, SpaceX posted this cool picture of the Orbital Launch Mount Water Deluge test. They said, after initial activation, a full pressure test of the new Starship flame deflector is planned for Friday. SpaceX posted this cool picture of that full pressure test on Friday. They also posted this video of the test too. There was another great video of this test posted by Elon Musk. In the production yard, here's a look at the progress on the Star Factory expansion. Interestingly, there is a new tent being constructed near Star Factory. The work on Mega Bay 2 continues with a new section lifted and installed. There was an article posted related to the FAA and SpaceX and the next Starship launch attempt. It says the FAA, which is overseeing an investigation into the April 20th launch, said Wednesday it was still awaiting the report it needs to identify corrective action SpaceX must take to get the okay to launch again from Boca Chica. An FAA spokesperson declined to speculate when the agency's investigation might be completed, saying that public safety and actions yet to be taken by SpaceX will dictate the timeline. S24.2 was seen moved into the mid-bay. There's some unfortunate news regarding the first Starship to stick the landing on a test flight and not blow up, SN15. The Post says, farewell SN15. SN15, the first Starship prototype to successfully complete a high-altitude suborbital test flight, has been scrapped. Ship 25 continues to sit on the Pad B test mount. What About It posted information related to the Starship 31 prototype. It says, interesting activity at Starbase yesterday. A payload door was installed on Ship 31. What are your thoughts? Will Ship 31 be the first to deliver Starlink satellites into low Earth orbit? We saw the pictures from SpaceX during the week of the Booster 9 cryo testing, but here's some footage of the test. Since the testing, work has been going on inside the booster. To finish up the video today, let's take a quick look at the Cameron County website. Whilst there are no full road or beach closures, there are temporary road closures posted. The temporary closures are for today, Sunday 30th, and tomorrow, Monday 31st through Tuesday, August 1st. As always, I have to say thank you to Jack Beyer for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.